Hello and welcome to Atmospheric Beasts. At the end of January of this year, I made the video about odd atmospheric events that happened in Oakville from the state of Washington. In this story, strange gelatinous orbs fell from the sky in 1994, and there are many conspiracies surrounding what exactly it was. One of those theories involved a being known as atmospheric beasts. As such, at the end of the video, I asked if you would be interested in hearing about these creatures. I was shocked to see that my comment section was full of responses where you overwhelmingly told me that you did want to know more about these beings. So, today, we are doing just that, and discussing a topic that doesn't get much limelight anymore. As a forewarning, this topic needs to be approached with a very open mind. While I am not sure how much I personally believe in this topic, I can enjoy the story for what exactly it is. So, with that in mind, let us begin. With our planet, many things remain unknown or unexplored, but the drive for understanding is always present. We see this with all the new variety of species that continue to be discovered in remote areas of the world, or even in the depths of the oceans. These stories even branch off into one of our favorite topics, which would be cryptids. As such, we have also looked skyward and wondered what type of creatures may inhabit the vastness of space surrounding Earth. Little did we realize that in doing so, those unknown creatures that we were looking for may have actually been closer than we may have originally thought. While these ideas are fascinating, there are tales, and yes, even sightings, of a type of creature that may fit into two paranormal categories, alien and cryptid. Many of us have gazed up at the sky on a sunny day and took note on how the clouds moved or at times what shapes they appeared to take on. Outside of this, there never was anything out of the ordinary to see, and so our eyes just returned to more terrestrial things. The shocking thing to learn is that apparently the sky that you were just observing may actually have contained a whole ecosystem of odd types of creatures. There are said to be various forms of creatures in the sky, but one of those is known simply as an atmospheric beast, or creature. They are described as being transparent to semi-transparent, but are also capable of changing their color to blend in with the clouds. They can range in size from a few meters to several kilometers in length, and normally don't appear to have any form of propulsion. Although, it should be noted that some have claimed that these beings actually resemble a strange type of whale, with fins and everything. Also, in some descriptions, they are described as looking like some type of odd dragon. For the most part, the eyes and mouth is rarely seen, but has been observed from time to time. In some sightings, they are said to be able to transform their body into a metallic shape, or in other variations, able to produce a glow around their bodies. With this ability, they can change their density at will. This may just give us the answer to the question that you are probably pondering right now. Why aren't planes running into them all the time? Well, if they can change their structure, then I guess they can make it so planes fly right through them? Even so, they are considered fairly fragile, and it is said if they touch the ground, they will die. But this theory has never been tested. Speaking of which, when they do die, their bodies are said to follow the Earth in the form of gelatinous orbs of various colors. This gel is commonly referred to as star jelly, and it will evaporate within minutes of touching the ground. This fact is fairly interesting, since there are quite a few instances around the world where such a substance has been described, and it simply fell from the sky. They are said to congregate in groups of others of their kind, and preferred to live high up in the atmosphere. Those who study these creatures claim that many of us have actually seen them and not realized it. They say that any time you see a cloud that appears to be mobile or forming differently than the rest is more than likely one of these beings. With that said, I can say that I have seen this happen from time to time. It even goes as far as stating that these beasts can also appear as fog. With creatures this large, you may wonder, what would they eat? From what I could gather, some believe that they consume carbon, but I have to wonder if they would consume a bird if given the chance. Others believe that there is another invisible being in the sky with them, which is a form of plankton, and they will eat that as well. All stories claim that they are not aggressive towards humans, which is obviously a good thing. One of the first reported sightings occurred on September 4, 1891, in Crawfordsville, Indiana. At 2 o'clock in the morning, two icemen named Marshall McIntyre and Bill Gray had quite a fright. As they were hooking up their ice wagon to the horses for the day's work, Marshall suddenly was overcome by a sense of awe and dread for no apparent reason. As he looked up, he saw a white mass that was about 8 feet long and 8 feet wide, swimming through the sky like a serpent, about 300 to 400 feet up. He claimed it had multiple fins, one red eye, and was emitting a wheezing sound. The creature flew towards town and then came back to where the two men were. It then stayed in this position, just hovering in the sky. Bill and Marshall jumped on their wagon and headed to town, but kept their eyes on this creature. They claimed that during this whole ride, the being just stayed in the sky where they had left it. On that same morning, the reverend from the local Methodist church, named G.W. Schweitzer, also saw this creature. As he was out getting a drink at his well, he also was overcome by an odd, overwhelming sensation. When he turned his gaze skyward, he saw the same white being flying nearby, but he described it as almost resembling a cloud. Only a couple days later, and the being would return, and this time at least 100 people saw it, and some even claimed that it produced hot breath. 4 days later, a report would come out that two men claimed to have followed the creature and stated it was simply a group of killdeer which had become confused by the lights of the town. Most end the story there, but they failed to mention that this report came out after the town's postmaster wrote an article complaining how much correspondence his office was receiving about the sighting. Also within that article, there was a concern with how many people were under the impression that the beast was a sign of the biblical judgment day. While I'm on the fence about atmospheric beasts existing, I do have to say that the explanation of it being a killdeer seems off. That doesn't explain the red eye, the wheezing sound, killdeer have a very distinct call, or the ability of this thing to hover in one spot for a long time. I think this explanation was brought forth to ease the postmaster's workload and to calm the public from panicking. That's just my two cents, though. There also is a report of a police officer who was riding his bike when he encountered a strange transparent being. It just appeared to be simply fog, but as he became enveloped in it, he noted how it had a strange smell of mildew and it had a feeling of a blanket. In saying this, I do recall hearing a story that I can't find presently, where two officers actually saw a glowing green cloud and they even fired upon it. If I remember correctly, one of the officers actually became mentally ill after the encounter. I'm not sure if this fits, but I found an article from Ann Arbor, Michigan that seems odd. On April 12, 1965, Ralph Myers and his son Keith were outside their house at 8:30 p.m. There had been a terrible storm which included a tornado prior to this. The pair were out trying to see how bad the storm was when suddenly Ralph noticed an odd cloud that appeared out of nowhere and was quickly moving towards them. As it flew over, it rained down pieces of a barn that was originally located on a neighbor's property. What made this odd was that the cloud wasn't funnel shaped, but more like a box, and it was a grayish green color. Again, it is common for the sky to turn green before a tornado, but this encounter seemed really odd to me. Now, atmospheric beasts are not considered alone, since there are many other versions of similar types of aerial creatures. Of course, there is the controversial sky rods, also known as skyfish, which, depending on what story you're looking at, can be a different type of being, a camera phenomenon, or just simply a bug caught at the right time in a photograph. Contrary to most beliefs, these creatures can be very small to over a couple feet long. They have been recorded on all types of medium, including video, but apparently they are normally undetectable by the naked eye. While these are an interesting topic, I think it would be best to focus on a creature that is more well documented and is very similar to the true atmospheric beasts. This type of creature is known as an atmospheric jellyfish. These beings are frequently suggested as the true culprit behind odd-looking UFO sightings. Much like atmospheric beasts, the jellyfish are said to frequently resemble odd-shaped clouds, or producing their own light. Probably the most obvious characteristic is the inclusion of tentacles of some form, which is commonly reported. As with all the creatures we have discussed, there really isn't a lot known about these beings outside of the eyewitness reports. What I love about this particular topic is that there is a lot of incidences of these being seen. The first image of this phenomenon was said to have occurred on November 17, 1974, and it was seen in Vyborg, Denmark. Apparently, many have tried to recreate this, but have thus far been unsuccessful. While that doesn't really mean much, since it would be really difficult to replicate a cloud, it should be noted that allegedly the Danish military were very interested in studying this phenomenon. While this does appear to be just an odd-shaped cloud, it is thought-provoking nonetheless. And remember, I warned you to keep an open mind at the beginning of this video. The next notable event occurred on October 19, 1998 in Tianjin, China. This image shows an object that was first seen on multiple military radar. They in turn sent out an interceptor to examine what exactly this object was. The crew described it as looking like a jellyfish with strands of light dangling from below it. The jet tried to get nearer to the being, but it kept outpacing the interceptor. However, it appeared to be toying with the crew, since it would keep quite a distance between them, only to vanish and reappear right above the jet. The pilot requested authorization to fire on the object, but was denied. After a while, the jet had to return to base to refuel, but in the meantime, the object disappeared when it shot off into space. It should be noted that this encounter was visible from the ground, and at least 140 other people witnessed it. This image was caught on January 10, 2010, in Andenes, Norway. It was taken by a photographer named Perdona Mikkelsen, and he was simply wanting to take a picture of the Northern Lights. Originally, he assumed it was a malfunction in his camera, but studies claim this wasn't the case. While some do think it is a jellyfish, scientists theorize it might actually be light reflecting off of a satellite. This image was taken on April 12, 2012 in Ontario, Canada. While not much is known about the story, the photographer did state that this object originally was seen slowly descending from the clouds before the image was taken. Here is another image that has very little backstory, but it was apparently caught on camera in December of 2012 and was released by a very unlikely source, NASA. There are claims that NASA has actually caught a lot of these similar images throughout the years. This next image could very well be a balloon, since there isn't a lot to go by with a still image. However, the story is that it was recorded on July 27, 2013 in Huanuco, Peru. They claim that this object changed shapes many times and extended and retracted its tentacles many times. Finally, this image was captured by a man named Harry Perton on June 1, 2015 in Groningen, Netherlands. Harry was taking images of the sky following a thunderstorm and later found that he had captured this. I know I previously said finally, but I did find an actual video from the Hidden Underbelly 2.0 YouTube channel where a passenger on a plane traveling from Phoenix to Portland around 2019 recorded this. Some claim that they are actually contrails from a twin-engine aircraft, but I think the turn is a little weird. If this does show a plane, then I can only imagine that the passengers in that craft must be having one wild ride. Now, I would be remiss not to mention that atmospheric beasts and jellyfish have a few origin theories about where they come from. Some assume that they have always been here, while others claim that they actually come from outer space. This may be an odd idea, but it does have a bit of plausibility behind it. This is only due to some astronauts claiming that they have seen such beings in space, as well as the previously mentioned NASA photographs. Another interesting theory is that these creatures are actually part of another plane of existence. In the moments we see them, it is when our reality merges with theirs. A few of my viewers suggested a very interesting theory, that it could be possible that those videos making its rounds on the internet, showcasing mysterious booming sounds from no apparent source, may be related to these creatures. Many state that these beings are silent, but I could see it being possible that if they do in fact exist, then why wouldn't they be capable of producing sound as well? The only thing that hurts this theory is that you would assume these sounds would be more common than they actually are. I don't know for sure though, so I can only assume anything is possible. So in ending this video, I hope I was able to provide you all with everything you ever wanted to know about a really strange group of beings that are said to reside in the sky. On a personal note, I am interested in this topic, but the moment we start having reports of sky sharks, then I'm done. If you haven't yet done so, do please consider subscribing to my channel for more content like this. Also, it would be greatly appreciated if you would share my videos with someone you know who may enjoy this type of genre. With that, be safe, and I'll see you in the next one. Later.